Ladies and gentlemen, how are we doing this morning?
Good!
Alright. I know you guys are three cars up, but can I get a little energy up there in car number two? How are we doing this morning?
Good!
That's more like it. If you're wondering where this voice is coming from, I'm all the way back here, all by my lonesome on car number five. You're more than welcome to give me a wave. Hi guys! I'm Jackson, I'm going to be your tank conductor on this ride around the mountain today. We're going to be talking a little bit about our park and its history. But before we get to all that fun stuff, we've got a few rules for you guys to make sure we have a safe ride. They're posted at the front of your train car, free to reference throughout the ride, but they are pretty simple. Rule number one, please remain seated while the train is in motion. Rule number two, please keep all hands, feet, and everything else inside the train at all times. And rule number three, for the safety and health of all, smoking is strictly prohibited on the train. So, without further ado, how many first-time riders do I have on my train today? Show hands, show hands. How many returning riders? Looks like everybody. All right, welcome back. Here's the refresher for you guys. Back here on the Rock Line Railroad, we have a bit of a tradition, something we like to do to show the engineer that we're ready for a rate right around the mountain. We say, all aboard. So, can I get your best? All aboard in 3, 2, 1. Thank you. ladies and gentlemen, so that horn reed here now coming up on the Stone Mountain Walk-Up Trail. So let us show, guys, how many of you guys have done the Walk-Up Trail before? Fantastic. Anybody planning on doing it today? Awesome. Well, for those of you that have not done the Walk-Up Trail before, it is about a mile long hike. It takes you about 30 to 60 minutes, and by the time you get to the top, you can see as far away as the skyline of Atlanta. But that's what we're about to do. There's another way to get to the top of the mountain. You can take just a little mountain SkyRide, which can take you 865 feet all the way to the top of the mountain in a very timely fashion. Walk-up trail, please wave to all these wonderful people as they either begin or finish their journey up the mountain. About our train, did you know the combined weight of our train engine and the Explorer weighs to about 381 pounds? That's about the size of 51 fully grown elephants, ladies and gentlemen. And these 51 fully grown elephants can go pretty fast. This train can get to speeds of up to 90 miles per hour. Now, unfortunately, we will not be going 90 miles per hour because we lack a very important component, seatbelts. Arrived and were greeted by a massive earthen wall erected all the way around the base of the mountain. By 1825, there was a regular stagecoach service to the mountain, and by 1845, the Stone Mountain Railroad was built. The railroad would bring plenty of international visitors, one such being the P.T. Barnum Circus, made famous by the recent hit movie, The Greatest Showman. Site of many different film projects, such as the most recent Godzilla King of Monsters movie, the most recent Jumanji movie, and the Netflix hit series Stranger Things.
Hello.
for this next stretch of the ride, I'm going to be turning on a PowerPoint with some various fun facts about Stone Mountain. Take your time to sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. Thank you. we are now slowly creeping into Pebble Ridge, the site of the current Stone Mountain Showgrounds. Like most of many of our shows throughout the year, one such being The Gift, our Christmas Nativity Show, that we host around the Christmas season. On the right, you'll see a large stone building. This currently serves as the Stone Mountain Train Shop, keeping most of our train engines throughout the year, but this building also has a darker history. It once served as the Stone Mountain Jail. It still has a few operable cells. As we move through Pebble Ridge, make sure to say hi to our Velociraptor friend hanging out in the general store on your left. This is a great time to remind you our Dinosaur Explore attraction is now open at the front of the park. History to them. They once served on the Long Island Railroad. That second car still having the lettering Long Island. The hiking trails around Stone Mountain. If you're more of a museum person, the Stone Mountain Quarry exhibit is on your left. This details all the different areas across the world where Stone Mountain granite resides. This includes, but is not limited to, the United States Capitol of Washington, D.C., the locks at the Panama Canal, and even as far away as the Imperial Hotel in Tokyo, Japan. Thank you. let me jump back up on my soapbox one last time. I'm going to be telling you the story of Mr. Elias North, the Stone Mountain Sun Devil. Mr. North was an acclaimed daredevil, his most famous stunt being when he drove a Model T Ford off the sheer face of Stone Mountain while on fire. He would also compete in regular competitions to see who could get down the sheer face of Stone Mountain the fastest. Mr. Noor was the undisputed champion with a final time of 4 minutes and 17 seconds. Sure that nobody did the crazy stunt that he did. If you want to learn more history of Stone Mountain, might I suggest Memorial Hall at the top of Memorial Lawn. Gentlemen, we are now slowly pulling back into the train depot and the end of our journey. As we pull to a stop, I'm going to ask that everyone please remain in your seats until I come up there and open the gates of your train car for you. Please feel free to expedite things and make sure that we all get out safely and quickly. But, other than that, I hope you have enjoyed your ride around the mountain. It truly has been my pleasure riding with you. I have been Jackson, you have been you, and enjoy the rest of your day at Stone Mountain Park!
This one, the snapper is not working on this one.
Okay.
This one's it.
So it wasn't going down, right?
Yeah, they're not working at all.
This one's not working.
Okay.
Thank you.
Explorers, and welcome to Time on Earth. In this game, you will need to select the creatures in the order of when they walked our planet. Start with the oldest and continue up to the most recent, but be careful. If you get one out of order, you'll have to start over. Good luck! You have 2 minutes to complete this game. Time is not on our side, Explorers. That's not quite right. Give it another go. That's not quite right. Give it another go. The Eoraptor is the earliest known dinosaur and walked the forest of what is now Argentina 230 million years ago. That's not quite right. Give it another go. The Eoraptor is the earliest known dinosaur and walked the forest of what is now Argentina 230 million years ago. That's not quite right. Give it another go. The Eoraptor is the earliest known dinosaur and walked the forest of what is now Argentina 230 million years ago. That's not quite right. Give it another go. The Eoraptor is the earliest known dinosaur and walked the forest of what is now Argentina 230 million years ago. Pterodactyls, while not technically dinosaurs, hunted the skies as far back as 200 million years ago. That's not quite right. Give it another go. The Eoraptor is the earliest known dinosaur and walked the forest of what is now Argentina, 230 million, 30 seconds to go. Pterodactyls, while not technically dinosaurs, hunted the skies as far back as 200 million years ago. The Stegosaurus wandered the plains of the western United States up to 160 million years ago. The mighty Tyrannosaurus Rex stomped around only 83.54. The Triceratops is the most recent dinosaur we know of, having found fossils dating from as little as 65 million years ago, right around the time the dinosaurs went extinct. Hey, Explorers, it's time to play Dino Says. Repeat the pattern of lights and sounds for as long as you can. Good luck! Level 1. Level 2. Level 3. Level 4. Level 5. Level 6. Dino Says! Your skills are dino-tastic!
rather have the winter weather anytime over this.
Oh, this is beautiful.
Guys, welcome aboard. We're heading to the top of Stone Mountain, and we are on our way at this time. Okay. How many first-timers do we have with us today? Anybody? Okay, you guys are first-timers. Okay, all right. Well, guys, we're heading up to the top of the big rock. It's 825 feet up to the summit of this big rock we call Stone Mountain. Once we get above the trees, the moment you'll be able to see the north face of Stone Mountain. The mountain itself is actually 583 acres in size. It is spread out over 25 million square feet. And once we get above the trees, you'll feel the SkyRide air conditioning system kicking in. And the train doesn't like me talking, so every time I say something, the train tries to load it with me. Well, guys, the north face of the mountain is right here ahead of us here. The Confederate carving is right on the north face. The carving itself is 90 feet tall, 190 feet wide, and it's recessed 42 feet into the side of the mountain. Confederate President Jefferson Davis is on the left-hand side. He's riding his horse, Blackjack. 6 foot tall person can stand right inside Blackjack's mountain. Robert E. Lee in the middle, his head is 15 feet tall. On the back of its horse, Triwork, two school buses can park right next to each other, side by side. And over there on the right-hand side is Stonewall Jackson riding Little Sorrel. Now the carving, believe it or not, is actually 30 feet taller than Mount Rushmore. Now the large picture frame that goes around the carving, the generals, is 3 full acres in size. Now the carving itself is not visible at this time, but you're now looking at Stone Mountain. This is the solid hunk of granite rock, 2 miles long, half a mile wide. Only 10% of this big rock, though, is what sticks up above the ground. The rest of it goes down underground. A good bit extends outward to the east, approximately 10 to 12 miles, and is around 2 to 3 miles in width. Now, your visibility up here today is real good. You've got about 60 miles of visibility. And up here, it's all fenced off on the top for you to walk around safely. Care to walk down the back of the mountain, just follow the broken yellow line that's 1.3 miles down the back of the mountain. Confederate Hall parking lot.
If you're okay, I can take your own. I can take the bag.
Guys, you are now at 1683 feet above sea level in height. You look over to the left, you can see this big TV tower over here. This is Georgia Public Television broadcast tower right here. TPTV. So if you watch any TPTV station in the area, they do broadcast from this tower you see right here to your left. So guys, if you have any questions about anything, feel free tomorrow morning about 9:30 to pick up your phone and make a phone call to Stone Mountain Park, and whoever answers the phone at that time might be able to answer any questions that you have. Now, the call center doesn't open until 10. So if you call at 9:30, lots of luck. Sometimes I get a chuckle out of that one. We don't even have a call center, so. Just whenever you call, whenever somebody's out of the URL and they answer, that's it.
How long have you been doing
this? Too long. Almost 4 years.
Does it come out
since? I've been doing this almost 4 years. And before this, I was on the Ducks. I was a captain on the Ducks for about almost last year. And prior to that, I went on the train. Did that for.
How long have you been doing this?
I was in the Navy doing the Vietnam
here.
Here
we go.
All right. We are leaving the platform and we're heading for the tower you see directly ahead. Once we get to the tower, we're going to go over the top of the tower, then we're going to tilt forward on Aladdin's magic carpet and being previewed nice and soft all the way down to the ground, way down below. So here we go. To the right, folks, is Stone Mountain Lake over here. This is 232 acres of Stone Mountain property. There's 200 acres total. The lake is a man-made lake, and it was created back in 1962 when the state of Georgia was creating Stone Mountain Park. Once again, behind us on the left here is the Confederate carving, which sits 400 feet up from the ground below. And the carving itself was completed way back in 1970. Below us on the left, the building with the long green roof, is the train depot. If you haven't rode the train, you'll want to get over there and climb aboard the train for a 5-mile excursion around the base of Stone Mountain. The large laser lawn to the left here below us here is where we would show our fireworks and laser shows each night through the summer months, but that's all been canceled for the rest of this year. Especially you ladies know much about the Yellow Daisy Festival, which takes place the weekend after Labor Day. They probably are going to be canceling that also. That looks like it might be a cancellation on that. The ticket to ride is your round trip ticket.
Oh, okay. They're like one ways and round trips.
Yeah.
Okay.
You guys walk up to have pay for one way to come down. Yeah. Yeah. If you want to go back up, yeah, you got to get another ticket. You can get a one way.
Okay.
You park over there at the Confederate Hall. You walk up, right?